I thought spending more meant getting more, but after using both, I can confidently say I should have just bought this and saved my money. Because at almost half the price, the P1S prints just as fast, just as good, and honestly, I don't even really use the premium features of the X1C. Let me show you why the P1S is the better value and why I regret buying the X1 Carbon. Now, if you're shopping for a Bamboo Lab printer, you've probably asked yourself one of two questions. Should I spend the extra money and get the X1 Carbon, or should I save some cash and go with the P1S? I had the same debate, and I spent way too much time in analysis paralysis before choosing the X1 Carbon. And now that I've owned the P1S, the A1, the A1 Mini, and the X1 Carbon, I really wish I would have just saved the money. Here's why. The X1C no doubtably has the better screen. Now, do I even really use it? Most of the time, I control my printer from my phone or my computer. And if I really want a touchscreen, the BigTreeTech Panda Touch makes the X1 screen even less relevant. Honestly, the screen difference isn't worth it in my opinion. Now, the X1C does have AI spaghetti detection, but how often do I really need it? The auto flow calibration is useful, but the P1S prints just as well out of the box without it. And for a feature that barely impacts daily prints, is it worth paying hundreds more? I honestly don't think so. While it has been nice to have those AI kind of features where if there is an issue with the print and it alerts you, it works and it works fairly well, but I honestly don't think it's worth the extra premium. And like I said, the P1S prints just as well without doing any of the flow rate calibration. And if I really wanted to, I could do the calibration through the slicer just manually.
So I just finished printing a Yoda bust from Fotis Mint over on MakerWorld. This is printed with the X1C, and this one is printed with the P1S. Now let's get these off the build plates and actually do a side-by-side comparison to see how good they look. All right, so here we have the bust printed with the X1 Carbon. There's tons of detail everywhere. This is a really great model from Fotis Mint. First layer is great looking. I marked an X here so I know which one this was printed off of. And now same thing, here is the P1S print, which, you know, just looks just as good. There's no issues here. Tons of detail. First layer looks great. So as you can see, these are basically identical. I cannot see any differences. Everything looks great. The X1 Carbon is on the right. The P1S is on the left. Can you tell any differences? Let me know down in the comments below. But just looking at these, they both look perfect. No issues, and they look the same. Here's another great comparison here of this minimalistic bunny from Saber Design over on MakerWorld. Left is the P1S, X is the right 1C, and as you can see, both printed out phenomenally. I can't really see any difference here. Yeah, I think these, it's just, they look good. There's no difference.
Both printers have great build quality. The X1 Carbon has a little bit more of a premium exterior with the metal shell rather than the plastic. And the X1 Carbon also does come with a hardened hot end, a more hardened extruder gear, but you can put all those on the P1S with stock bamboo parts or even third-party parts like the BigTreeTech's hardened extruder or hot end. Now, I did do a bento box air filter upgrade for my X1 Carbon, and you could do the same for the P1S. You should definitely check that video out in the description below. For way less than the cost of the difference, you can turn your P1S into an X1C-like machine. As you can see up on the screen here, both these printers print phenomenally without any issues. Now, the biggest question, should you buy the P1S or the X1C? You know, both printers are amazing, but after using them both, I really don't think that the X1 Carbon is worth almost double the price. The P1S has nearly identical print quality and speed. It's cheaper up front and cheaper to upgrade. The AI feature and screen aren't really worth the extra costs, especially when you can add a screen from BigTreeTech. There's even a free add-on for these printers where you could add AI features for free. I'll put a link down in the description for that because honestly, I can't remember the name of it off the top of my head. Really, the X1 Carbon only really wins on having a slightly more premium build quality. It does have the auto flow calibration, which really isn't all of that game changing. You can get that on the A1 and the A1 Mini, which are significantly less expensive machines. If I would have to do this all over again, I would just get the P1S and put the saving towards upgrades or even more filament, or even buying two P1Ss. Now, let me know, what do you think? Did you struggle with this same decision? Let me know down in the comments below. And before you go, you really should check out this video right here where I upgraded the air filtration on these printers.